Last time I spoke to you, you were up for an award. You were going up against AKA and stuff like that. Yeah. But you're one of those guys that seem to understand what the music game's about. Or is that a difficult thing to say to you, that you understand what the music hip hop business is all about?
I learn, you know. So yeah, I might not take that completely. You know, I mean, I do it and I learn what it's about. You know, I'm still not sure what it exactly is about. But I've just always figured it's always been about the music. Everything else that happens around it has never really mattered to me. You know, has never really affected how I do the music. You know what I mean? There's all these marketing strategies and brand positions and everything else that always seems to mess with the music. But all I care about at the end of the day is just making sure that the music is of proper quality. Yeah.
Let's talk about that quality, because that quality is based on experience, based on life experience, based on what you're going through, influences, outside influences. But apart from writing about it, you have to kind of live through it.
Yes.
How do you manage those difficult moments to eventually we hear it in the song and we go, wow, that's a great song, but we're not understanding that Quest is talking about something that's important to him, something that affected him, that changed his psychological state?
I mean, that's the difference between, I think that's what makes an artist, that's what people like in an artist, you know, a certain way of telling a story, you know. I think for me personally, if you're unable to document your life and put it on some, and you're an artist kind of situation, and you can't document your life, and I as a fan don't feel like I'm connecting with you, then for me you're wronging me as a fan of, you know, of whatever you do, you know. So I think it's just very important to be honest first in the music, you know, and not be selective with whatever we say to people just to try and sound cool or whatever. You know what I mean? If there is rough patches, put that in a song. You know, if you're not doing too well, and if you are doing well, put that in a song also, so that people follow something that's honest. You know, so I've always believed in that, and that's what I always try and do.
I want to talk to you about just the year that was for you, but quickly I just want to talk about that competition in the hip hop game, because but all of a sudden it hip hop seems to have really come into its own. I mean, it's always been there, whether it's been underground, there's always been guys working the scene, working very hard, but all of a sudden, and there's this focus on hip hop, whether it's good or bad, and you can mention the names, you're part of that. How do you not measure what you're doing up against where anybody else, like AKA for example, who walked away with so many awards at the hip hop awards? How do you make sure that you keep what you're doing to what you're doing and not try and compare your success to somebody else?
I mean, what happens naturally, because we're human beings, it does happen that you compare yourself to other people, you know what I mean? Because that's what's out there, whatever's out there, you kind of also say, oh, I'm doing this and they're doing that kind of situation, because that's what you keep playing. But you don't let that decide what you're doing, you know what I mean? That's what I try and do. I mean, everyone's doing well, like you were saying, AKA walked away with a lot of awards.
Casper's doing well.
Casper's doing amazingly well.
He's had phenomenal year. The Les just brought up a deep of money.
You know what I'm saying? So it's been a big year for hip hop generally, you know, but both the controversy and the fact that people have accepted it for what it is, and now it's actually a thing where people are, it's the most talked about genre, you know what I mean? It's no longer just an accent or a certain way to walk, and it actually affects dance floors and parties. It's the most there's influence, you know, from the youth to even older people, you know. So I mean, it's been one of those years, but you try and stick out and you try and do your own thing and try and create an identity within that whole thing. You don't really try and follow suit or follow or try and sound like anybody else, even though everyone is having a good year. What you don't try and do is do the same thing that they do.
In 10 seconds, big moment for you this year? What was the standard moment?
Big moment for me this year, the Metro Award Best Hip Hop and the Best Lyricist at the South African Hip Hop Awards.
I think your fans will agree with you as well. Yeah. Okay, we've got more from this. I don't like to use the word young, but he's young. This young artist coming up. Kwesta's going to play out the show for us, and he'll be with us for the rest of the show. Now, 9-time Grammy Award winner and multi-platinum selling artist John Legend was in our country.